Question of the day for you. What would you do with an extra $140,000? You ever get tired of paying those electric bills? Keeping that air conditioner turned up so you're not spending so much on electricity? I'm Dan Puckett with Iconic Energy. I'm here to tell you why it makes dollars and cents to go solar. Hey, there's many reasons to go solar. The two most popular reasons, one is financial, and two is to reduce your carbon footprint. The average bill in the Midwest is approximately $100, which is about 833 kilowatts a month, which rounds out to about 10,000 kilowatt hours a year. Now, as you can see by this chart, your bill right now is $100, but what's going to happen as it keeps going up? That bill is going to turn into $243 after 30 years. And this is because the power companies have a monopoly and they can raise the prices. Average across the United States is approximately 5% a year. In the Midwest, we average about 3%, and that's what this chart shows. The only way you can really hedge your bet against rising energy costs is to go solar. Now, the question I get is, how much does it cost? Well, let me help you with that. I have an example here that will show you what we can do to help eliminate your bill. Now, this bill here, this is what we use for our example. So this person's bill is about $100 a month, which is the 833 kilowatts. Now this is 24 panels on a shingle roof with no shade. So it's pretty easy for us to give you an idea of what it's gonna cost and what your incentives were gonna be. Now here's what I have for you. We have an estimate here for this particular system. It's $19,105. Now, don't get excited. You think that's a really big number, but it's really not. Once we start looking at what's going on here, you can see that we have some incentives that are going to help reduce that amount. So this particular system here would qualify for 26% federal tax credit, which in this case is just under $5,000. Now, if you take a look at that and then include the state incentives, which different states have different incentives, where this particular house was located, we would end up with 71% of the system being paid for. Now, if you're interested, depending on what state you're in or where you are in the Midwest, you can give us a call and we'll be able to tell you what your incentives are going to be. But if you think about that, if you could get 71% of your system paid for, why wouldn't it make sense to go solar? Now, the next reason people go is to reduce their carbon footprint. Now, about 60 to 70% of our power comes from fossil fuels. Now, it depends on who you talk to, where that number comes from, but let's just say it was 60% in the Midwest that we get from fossil fuels. By going solar, one house going solar on an average bill is going to reduce that amount of oil that it would use by 470 barrels. It's like if you planted over 5,000 trees and had 165 acres of forest, reducing the CO2 carbon footprint. So you can see that going solar really does make dollars and cents. Your return on investment on this particular situation is about 4 years. And then if you look at the planet, look how much you've saved here. Now at the beginning of this recording, I asked you, what would you do with an extra $140,000? And what I did to get that number was, the $100 a month that someone was actually spending, if you took that and invested it over the next 30 years, you would end up with $140,000. That's a little kick into your retirement. So if you don't think solar makes dollars and cents for you, please give us a call and we'll show you how it really does work. For anybody who wants to give us a call or to fill out the form below this podcast, we will be glad to send out a solar consultant and help you. We'll spell everything out just like we did here, show you what your situation is and how much money you can save by going solar. I'd like to thank you for really joining us on our very first video podcast. Look for more to come. And if you do have any questions, please feel free to contact us.